I follow the news pretty closely. I'm a pretty big news junkie, which I think is the worst kind, because at least regular junkies will chase stuff that makes them feel good. You know? Even heroin addicts get to be chill when they get their fix. You can't be chill on news. And when you're on drugs, you can entertain the delusion that it'll get better. When you're on news, you know that shit isn't true. But I can't help it. I can't not get my fix. I can't not. But I don't blame me for that. I blame Trump, because now the news has cliffhangers, and that isn't healthy. Right? Cliffhangers need to be for fake stuff, so you can still go to sleep at night, right? The Sopranos, Breaking Bad. Does he die? Does he live? Well, he's not real, so it doesn't fucking matter. You can catch some Z's. You can't do that when it's the President of the United States ending every press conference with, okay, no more questions. Also, I might bomb Iran. Good night, everybody. Like, no, don't roll credits. What? Son of a... But you can't to be continued foreign policy, motherfucker. Like, that's not right. I think Trump's the first president we've had that's aged less fast than the American people. Like, I... It's not right. It isn't right. He looks the exact same. I've aged 12 years. That's not fair. He's the first president we've ever had whose death would throw the country into stability. Like, that's where we're at right now. He's gone from hosting The Apprentice to hosting Survivor, and we're all playing. That's a terrifying thing. I feel like race relations have also gotten a lot worse under Trump. And I'll tell you how I know. We had a solar eclipse not that long ago. You know what that means? Trump, he hasn't even been in office for a full term, and even the sun's wearing blackface. Like, that's... How bad? That's how bad it's gotten. Even the environment's doing shit it shouldn't be doing. You know, like how every Halloween there's a few dumb white guys in the South that get busted wearing blackface? It's actually doubly dangerous for them in the South, because on the one hand, they're going to get caught, they're going to lose their job, which they should. But also in the South, if your blackface looks authentic enough, they don't let you vote, which is unfortunate on a number of levels. I'll tell you what blew my mind the most about Trump was the fact that in that election in 2016, he was clearly the underdog. No one thought he was going to win. Everyone knew he was the underdog, but not a likable one. He was an unlikable underdog. Like, I don't even think that was a thing, an unlikable underdog. That's like if Rudy hated Jews, you know? Or if Rocky was a racist, and then after fighting Apollo Creed, instead of shouting, Adrian, he shouted segregation. You're like, oh, shit, I didn't know he thought that. I regret supporting him now. Can they fight again? Nope, 4 years. God damn it. All right, that's unfortunate. I mean, obviously, it's not fair to compare Trump to Rocky, you know. Rocky stood up to Russia, but... Even our polio president had a stronger backbone. But I think, never, thank you. That did not go over as well in Sheboygan. I think it was all his slogan. I think he just had a very winnable slogan, a slogan people could get behind. I think that's all it takes to win in this day and age, is just a good slogan. Which is why I think if the Democrats really want to beat him in 2020, they'll just run Kevin James, and his motto will be free tacos. Fuck it. Well, how are you going to pay for those tacos? Make Mexico pay for the tacos. They have the ingredients.